Hi, my name is Jean, and this is my channel, Learn with Jean. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to create a multicam video in Descript. What's a multicam video? This could mean, let's just say you're doing a remote recording, you're doing a remote Zoom interview with someone else, or you're interviewing a couple people for a video podcast. So regardless of whether you use Zoom or whatever you use, in the case of this example I'm going to show you, my sister used Squadcast. And basically, when you do a remote recording in Squadcast, they give you the files for each individual person on the recording, separate files. The beauty of that is awesome because it makes your life easier instead of having to transcribe an entire Zoom video and then assign different speakers. Squadcast gives you the individual's files and then you upload them in Descript, transcribe them, and assign them a speaker, and then put it into a multicam sequence. So in this tutorial, I'll show you how you can take your Squadcast recordings and make it a fun multicam video. If you aren't using Squadcast, I would consider using and exploring it because it really makes remote recording so much easier, especially because you get individual files that you can render, transcribe, and repurpose. And especially in the case of when you're doing remote podcasts and remote video interviews, having the files individually allows you to do more with those individual transcripts. And then when you put it into this multicam sequence, and when you put the individual files in a multicam sequence, you'll see that it makes your life so much easier. It makes your workflow so much faster, which saves you time, money, and energy. Now let's get started in this tutorial. First of all, what you're seeing here is the end product. So this is what happens after I've brought the two videos into Descript, transcribed them, and created a sequence so that there is multi-tracks. And then in order to make this presentable, I applied the templates from Descript's library, and I elevated slightly, not a ton. I just basically tried and cleaned up the background and just added a background color. You can add whatever color or style you like, but I just wanted to make it a little bit nicer. So I made the background color blue. You can go with purple. And then I added a title so that this is a promotional video for a workshop that they are doing. And when they're showing this video, it's nice to have a little bit of a title so people know what they're watching. As we all know, the attention economy is shorter and shorter every day. It used to be just Facebook posts, but now it's Reels and TikTok. So I try to make this very easy and very simple so that people who are watching know what they're watching. So now you're like, great, Jean, I see how this is done. Now show me the steps. First of all, I'm going to click on a new video project. And this is important because this video project is how you will begin the multicam sequence. And so it is loading right now. And then now what I'm going to do is click on this play button, or you could call it a media button. And then I'm going to go and add the two files that Squadcast has sent me. So I'm going to click on add files, and it's going to open up my computer, and then I'm going to attach and select the two files I want added. Now that I've added these two files into my Descript media library, what I want to do is start with one file and create a sequence. It is still loading. It will take a little bit of time. Thankfully, these are short clips, but I can still go ahead and show you the process. So I'm going to take one video, and then I'm going to click on this three dots, and I'm going to go click on create sequence. And this will open up the multi-track panel. And so now you see there is one track in here. And now I want to add a second track so that it knows that it's a multi-track sequence. And then I'll click on add media again. And this is where I will pull the other video, so that they know that this is going to go under here, and we'll turn this into a multicam video. And I'm going to click on it and then click on add new track. And now I have these two tracks. Now, if you had more than two people in an interview, you can continue this process and click on add media and then add a, or click on new track and then add the media file, video file, for that next person. So now that I'm done, I'm going to click on done. And then I want to, while that is uploading, now click on insert into script and have these two videos show up here. And so now you can see that those two videos are side by side in here. And then what I did was click on this template library and go into the drive. Oh, sorry. Template library, look in the gallery, look for multicam, and then look for the modern two camera scene. If you have three camera, you can choose from three camera, but I chose the two. Now I wanted to, it's applying the template right now. It'll take a little bit of time, but the cool thing about the template is that you can add the social media handles. You can change the background color. You can add some music. I would add music just because they're talking and you just, unless the music really complements their promotional video, but as long as the music is not too loud, that's something you can do. And then I would change the background color instead of black. I can change it to yellow. That's one thing I can do. Go back to this rectangle, click on this. I know sometimes it's a little funky, and click on my template. Okay, so now you can see the template has been applied. It's a little bit of a light color, so the background is like a little light white cream, but I can change it. And like I said earlier, I made it blue, but let's just try yellow. So now we applied it, so it's like a fun yellow. And then these layers will show you. These layers are all the different layers in this composition. So we have the two video tracks, and then we have the rectangles for each of the side-by-side gallery, Zoom gallery or Squadcast recording, whatever you use, and then the social handles for each person. Those are already part of the template. And so I would suggest, if you have trouble like with these boxes and making sure that you can see the social handle correctly, I would expand on the box and then type it in. I think that's a little bit easier sometimes than just going right in. And then I'll click on type it, Rachel Lipton Coaching. I don't know if that's exactly something like that. That was the handle. And then I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, 30. And then I can move it up here. And then what you want to do sometimes is it doesn't always show very well. So you want to make sure that the black text blends in really well. So it's right now it's a black, but I can shrink this and go with a different color, an orange, and make this orange. And then if I go on the timeline, I can also manipulate it here. So you can see I've added the Rachel Lipton Coaching, and then I can move it up a little bit more. And then same thing here, I can make this the same bigger. Sometimes it's a little tricky working with it, so I try to make it bigger and then adjust it there, 30. And then I think her handle is Style by Janet. And I'll delete the rest of this. Oh, Janet. And then, I don't know, maybe I'll change the color, maybe I won't, but I can move it up so I can move it next to this little hyphen here. And then if I want, I can add a hyphen for her, or if I don't like the hyphen, I don't have to add it. But, and then if you want to add a title, just click on the T, and then for title, and then there you have a title box, and a promo video. So now what I'm going to do is move it here, and then expand. I think it's a little too big. I'm going to have to make it smaller so that it fits 100. So now it will be smaller and I can shrink it there. So now I have a video, promotional video, that I took from a Squadcast remote recording. So that is how you make a multicam video in Descript. Let me know if you have questions, comments, or feedback. I think this is really fun and it's really easy to do. The other thing is that even if you mess up and you start from the existing video, so like before when I was playing around with this, what I did was I can show you what I did before. I'm gonna pause it so I can pull up the file. And it works really well even if you mess up like I did. I was playing around with a different version where I took in the composition my sister's video, And then I tried to add Rachel's video and make it a multi-cam sequence. And I did, but I inserted into her existing script. So now I have two videos in here. So what I can do is just easily select on this and delete it so that I just have this one multi-cam video. So that is what makes Descript really flexible and really easy to use. And I hope this tutorial helps. Let me know if you have questions, comments, or feedback. And I'll talk to you soon. Thanks for watching.